Tonga's borders are compromised by the very people tasked to protect it. A member of one of Tongatapu's five major meth syndicates has revealed customs and police are on their payroll and others.
Our stuff comes in containers. The people they're operating, they know and they let it out. Once customs lets it out, we get a call.
Sometimes the recipient of the container doesn't even know meth is hidden inside. The syndicate usually has kilos, with more always on the way from Australia.
One time we were short. We went to a Chinese guy to get some stock from him. They are trying to make their own because of the growing need.
Strengthening vulnerable borders is the top priority, but the police need help.
In the airport and the border, we are not in the, we were not well resourced.
Foreign Minister Winston Peters says what help New Zealand can provide is under discussion, including funding the kingdom's only rehabilitation program.
Well, it also would help not just the Tongans people, but also help the New Zealand people as well, in the sense that there's a lot of trading going on, illegally through the back door, of course, and we need to put a stop to it.
If the Indigenous syndicates tap into the Pacifica demographic here in New Zealand, that will definitely impact the usage. We cannot underestimate just how fast both Indigenous and transnational crime syndicates can take hold and infiltrate throughout all different levels of society.
There's calls to set up a regional crime group with no links to any police force to stamp out leaks.
And that would probably be the only one of the few tactics which we could utilise.
In recent times, the meth trade has been operating underground, but it's now reached such proportions that people are speaking openly about it.
Tonga's youth parliament wants the government to set up a drug education centre.
There is definitely a need for political will to do something about it, to decrease the supply, decrease the demand, decrease the impact that it's having on families.
Families desperate to protect their children from the scourge of meth. Barbara Dreaver, One News.